Just thought I'd get some of the shot.
It's very nice, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Sitting here.
That's okay.
This is a dairy free, sugar free, and
no, you're nervous.
I am very nervous.
Yeah.
She's a really great book over there, and I hope you guys enjoy this. It's a chocolate decadent cake she's going to be baking today, or cooking today, sorry. And I hope you enjoy the demonstration.
Thanks, Melissa. Like Melissa, on most of my occasions, I've been very nervous. So today I don't have to be nervous. She can be nervous for me. my cookbook is inspired to make really great tasting food using local, sourcing local, cooking with natural ingredients, and making things really simple for you. So a lot of people think chocolate desserts, oh, there's got to be a lot of work involved. There really isn't. So I'm going to show you today how to make a chocolate decadent lavender cookie cake or cake that has some graham wafers, has some chocolate, some lavender, of course, from the farm that Melissa and Robert gave me, some raisins and cranberries. So I'll get started.
Absolutely. So how are we going to get started? You want me to switch sides
with you? Yeah, you want to give me a hand?
Absolutely.
Okay.
So
we need to start a fire. That'd be the first one, start a fire.
Sure, that sounds great.
So what we're going to do is we're going to caramelize the nuts, is one of my favorite parts of baking, because I'll caramelize nuts for almost anything, whether it's desserts or salads or topping on whatever. So we'll get the nuts started.
Okay, so
what I've done with this cookbook is I've actually had some really great people match or pair wines with desserts, mains, and appetizers. And Chef de Charme is actually in the cookbook as well. They've decided, the gentleman that paired up the wines decided that this would be a perfect fit for the chocolate and lavender taste. So if you're making a tour around Niagara, have a stop in there and they have this available there. It's an iced wine. So we'll get the,
perfect.
Just remove the cookies and we'll get the walnuts going.
And
I'll
blast it off.
Yeah. It doesn't matter. It's all good.
Nope.
Good. And then just get the, she's going to put the raisins and the cranberries in the same bowl.
So it's just a mixture here of them both. Ready to go. Put this right in the bowl.
We're going to wait. We're going to put chocolate in there. So the next step would be to break one egg in, whisk it in. Yeah, you put the egg in, you whisk it in. It actually kind of loosens up the chocolate. It makes it not quite so tight. So if you don't put it in, it's just going to be a little bit tighter. So I'm going to take, see the chocolate? Oh, and don't forget, Melissa, we need to put the lavender in.
Oh my goodness.
That's why we're here. It's for the lavender. So you can just put, you know, yeah, you could put as much lavender as you like based on your palate, based on what you want it to taste like.
We're all here today, so I want a little bit more. So we actually taste it.
Yeah. Okay, and then I'm going to put the chocolate in.
Can everyone smell the chocolate in the air now? It smells great, doesn't it?
Unsweetened chocolate.
chocolate or is it semi-sweet?
No, it's unsweetened. It's dark chocolate. I always use a dark chocolate. You'd be surprised. Most of you have tasted the samples that I've brought. There's no sugar added. It's just maple syrup. So there you go. Give it a stir. Tiny little ones here. This recipe can make a large loaf pan, or you can use the little ones, or you can actually use the smaller muffin tins. You can use whatever you like for whatever occasion that it is you're doing.